In this video, I'm going to talk through what hardware is important for running After Effects, what parts I put in the PC I built, and at the end, I'm going to talk through a piece of tech that I'm loving from this week's sponsor, Gigabyte. I've been using the AERO 15 OLED for weeks now, and it is by far the fastest laptop I have ever used. And it has this beautiful 4K AMOLED screen. But more about that later. Here's my workspace. I've got two monitors, a Wacom Cintiq, a mechanical keyboard, and a mouse. Underneath, I've got this, and here's what's in it. I researched for months to make sure I was buying components that were going to be the most cost-effective for the best performance in After Effects, and that would help my workflow the most, which, typical for a 2D motion designer, is a lot of Illustrator, Photoshop, but mostly After Effects. For a CPU, you want a higher speed with fewer cores. That's much better for After Effects than, let's say, a lower speed with many multi-multi cores. Your RAM. More RAM means less time RAM previewing. It won't necessarily render faster, but it will render more frames, so you'll spend less time buffering.
16
gigabytes would be the minimum I'd go for with your RAM. 32 is probably your safest bet, and 64 if your budget allows for it. But you can always upgrade later. Your GPU, the graphics card. Graphics card doesn't need to be too intense for After Effects. As of 2019, After Effects doesn't take that much advantage of GPU rendering, so it might not be the most cost-effective thing to splash out on a really high-end graphics card. But if you're working in 3D or considering dabbling in 3D in the future, you might want to consider investing in a high-end one. A decent solid-state drive is also a must, but that's going to be pretty much a given in any new machine. Ideally, you'd have a separate one for your media, for your operating system, and your cache as well, but it's not essential. I don't have separate ones for all of those. 500 gigabytes should be good. 1 terabyte if you can really afford it, but you know, they tend to get pricey. A 4K screen is also ideal as well, mainly because of how much space After Effects takes up. Once you add all your panels and all your plugins, you can end up with a pretty small space for your composition window and your timeline. So I like to have a lot of real estate. I love a dual monitor setup as well. It's certainly not essential. I only ever use After Effects in one window. I've tried a bunch of layouts and workspaces where the timeline's separate on a couple of different monitors, but it just doesn't work for me. So I stick to one monitor and have, you know, a secondary one for my reference. And if you can, I highly recommend a mouse with a horizontal scroll wheel. It makes scrubbing through timelines so much easier. For all your other components, motherboard, power source, just make sure they're compatible. You don't need to break the bank on those. The previous machine that I used before building that PC was a mid-2012 MacBook Pro, and all the studios that I'd worked in up until that point had all used iMacs. I had a budget of $3,000 Australian at the time to build my machine. The iMacs were just ridiculously overpriced with the hardware included, so I begrudgingly made the jump to PC. The first few weeks were a little tricky to get used to, but it was mainly the keyboard layout and Windows Explorer that took the longest. So if you're thinking of making the jump to PC, be brave, you'll be fine, just stick through the first few weeks. The newest addition to my studio is this laptop that was sent to me by this video sponsor, Gigabyte. It is the AERO 15 OLED. It is a specced up laptop that's aimed at creatives rather than gamers. And it has all of those components to get a high performance out of After Effects and more. It'll run After Effects like butter.
When I was buying the stuff for my PC, all of the high-end components and peripherals were all targeted towards gamers and looked like they were all designed by a person whose only source of inspiration was men's razors, and everything had LEDs that screamed every color of Mountain Dew. So it's very refreshing to have something as powerful with a much subtler design. And inside it, we've got an Intel Core i7 9th Gen CPU. But the graphics card does stand out. We've got an NVIDIA RTX 2070, which makes light work of my most heavy projects. If you're using 3D applications, this card is going to help you out a lot. Way more powerful than the one in my big desktop machine. And we've also got a very healthy 500GB SSD, 16GB of RAM, but my favorite two things are this ridiculous 4K AMOLED screen, which is insane for any screen, let alone a laptop. And best of all these ports. Ports after ports. With ports like these, you won't ever have to take your dongle out. It's also damn light for everything packed in there, just 2 kilograms. I've been using it for the past few weeks and its speed is ridiculous. I've gotten used to taking a tea break when I need to RAM preview on a laptop, but this thing handles whatever I throw at it, no problem. I had to go out of my way to add unnecessary blurs and glows and all sorts of textures to even make it break a sweat.
I think it's really important for good hardware to stay out of your way as much as possible. If your designer animation has to be compromised because of render times or playback speeds, That's a real shame. The ideal hardware lets you focus on what you're creating, and the AERO 15 OLED certainly does that. I've made a short playlist of some related videos that I think you'll enjoy if you've made it this far. I'll see you in the next video, and please consider subscribing if you'd like more of these videos every week.